Hello everybody, welcome to a special edition on VIP Art Digital Art Channel. My name is Catalin and I'm a designer for fun. In today's video, we're gonna do the review of one of the shops that one of our friends is struggling with. The shop has been on for 7 months and has no sales whatsoever. So let's see what is it about and how we can help this seller to increase their sales. So without further ado, let's start working. Hello, welcome back to my computer. And voila, this is the shop that we're gonna review today. It's called Lenshen. I hope I pronounced it correctly. And now let's see what information can we gather from the shop at the first view. So in my case, I want to consider myself as a buyer. So when I come here, I'm looking at them and I can see 35 design and this shop is pretty new. But when I look here, what can I see? They are text-based designs. That's fine. And I can see sponsored by Sarcasm and Caffeine. Ooh, I like this one. But I don't like how it looks like on the t-shirt. And here, what is this? I can't see. Because I said so. I like this one. But I don't really like the font that much. What's this on? Cancer Cure. I can't really see it. V is for Virtual Valentine's. I like this saying, but the graphic doesn't look so well on the t-shirt. What to do? I really like those things, but I don't think I'll buy. I think I'll just go to another design. Okay, now we had a quick look as a seller point of view. Let's see, what can we do in order to improve this? So we see this person joined from August and has 35 designs. Here many people will say, so many months and only 35 designs. Well, I can tell you, it doesn't really matter. I saw many favorite artists and they are only having 17 designs, 12 designs, and they joined for more than a year. And they are favorite artists, by the way. As long as you have really cool designs and your tagging and everything is well optimized, it doesn't really matter having 12 designs, 1,000 designs, as long as you are making sales. So having 13 designs, I don't think is a bad issue. Now, what is really important here, first of all, we try to optimize the text in order to fit the background, okay? And let's head over to Photoshop and let's take one of the sayings from here, something that is easier, okay? Tired as a mother. So let's go to Photoshop. I will just choose the text and just write tired as a mother, okay? Now, right now, let's choose, because I do not know exactly what font you're using. So I will just use something similar, like Arial Black. So we have this. So we're gonna try to solve the issues as much as possible. Now, if you have this text, as tired as a mother, perfect on a white background, it looks okay. But what happens if I change the black background to black? Well, your text is gone, isn't it? So how can we solve this without going here, tired as a mother, and here, one thing that we can do is very easily change the from black to white, and now you have it solved. But let's see, you don't want to do that. You wanted to have the black as the original color. No problem. We just double click here, and we click on the stroke, and you add a stroke. And you can choose any colors you want. In our case, we let it white and you can increase the size or decrease the size. You can click outside of the text so you always have the same font. And we click OK. Now, if I switch back to white, problem solved. I switch back to black, problem solved. If I put this on a sticker again, it will look much more better than before, isn't it? So keep that in mind when you are trying to make your text-based design t-shirts. Let's go back here. As you can see, all the font is very simple, basic font. So why not taking it to the next level? What do I mean by that? Do not use this font because this one doesn't really attract the clients. And if you look here, the font, it takes way too less space on a t-shirt. We want to expand the text, as much as possible. So how to do that? Change the font. Let's choose another type of font. Choose as bolded as possible. For example, we can choose Baloo and the text becomes bolded and rounded. It's more attractive. Or Modek. You can see it's very round, it's very thick, very boldy. And you can click OK. And now it looks more attractive than before. You can also play around with the spacing. So here we can go to properties and we can space a little bit the letter distance so we have more definition, something like this. It looks better, isn't it? And if you want, you don't have to keep it in a line, you can just tie it as a mother. You can have it like this. And while one advantage of using Photoshop, here you have wrap system. So you just click on the wrap style and here you can choose any type of wrap. You want it to make it as an arc, you can write it like this and it looks really cool. And beneath of it, you can put a drawing. And let's click this and let's see what can I put inside here. Okay, and let's bring here and let's increase the size of these two. Okay, I think. And now if I bring your text beneath and let's try to optimize it. As you can see, your text already looks better than it was, isn't it? And let's see on the t-shirt, because the t-shirt is the most important part. And you can see, tired as mother, it looks already different than what we have here. So let's see if I change the background to white, your problem is solved already without too much work from your side. So by doing this, what we have done, we changed the font to make it something more bolded, much more into your face, because when you're using text designs, you want them to be as bolded as possible. The person who bought it, they bought it for the text and they wanted to show it to the world. If your text is very small and not bolded, like for example, like this one, the person who is wearing it, even though he wants to show it to the world, the others one, they have to struggle to see the message. They have to go like, what's that? I can't read very well. Well, you don't want that. You want it to be like in your face. Let's see, what else can we do? The design placement. Okay, let's get head over. Now, make sure your design is not placed here. Okay, because I saw some of your design are placed down. Why? We want the design to be placed on the chest area. Easily. Don't go all the way through the neck, somewhere between the middle of the chest to below of the chest. Okay, so this text, try to place it somewhere around here, something like this. Don't go all the way to up, because that one the text will just pop out at the neck area and will look really, really awkward. So just try to find a place somewhere like this. If you do not know exactly where to place it, you can always draw yourself some guides. Okay, try to use this as a guide. Okay, so once you put this line here, you know now where to place your design. So your design should be somewhere centered to this one, or even a little bit higher, and it will look much more better on t-shirts, isn't it? Now we solved this issue as well. Now another thing that we can do, you can add some graphics to your t-shirts. And by the way, if you are not using Photoshop and you're like, I don't want to buy Photoshop, and you are looking for a free solution, yes, you can use Canva. Canva is free, but remember, you do have the white background, and that one, if you want to remove the background, you have to pay for it. Now, I want to show you free solutions to that, something that you don't have to pay. You don't have to buy Photoshop. You can use whatever other softwares. But the free alternative that you can use is called Photopia. Photopia, it's a free version of Photoshop that you can use it online. And you can do the same things that you just go here, file, new, and then here you choose the dimensions that you want for your t-shirts, and then you're gonna click create. And once you click create, then you're gonna use it the same as Photoshop. So everything that I have done here, you can do it there for free without purchasing any additional softwares. Now, let's take your graphics to the next level. So for that, we want to add some elements. If you are using Photoshop, you have access to different custom shapes. But if you, let's say you are not using Photoshop and you still want to get free graphics, well, a free solution is to go to pixabay.com. And then here, for example, let's say tired as a mother. So we write tired mother. Okay, and here I don't want images, I want illustrations. And now let's wait for the page to load. Well, we haven't found nothing. So let's remove this Let's write mother. Now, when you go here, be careful. Here you have the sponsored image. If you click here, you may need to buy those images. So you don't want that. So you want to always go for here. We have 1,771 free images that are connected to mother. And whatever you like, you just take from here and you add it into your project. Let's see, I like this one, for example. Now I can download it. But it's not something that I really enjoy. So let's use vector, for example. You can use this one, and this one looks pretty cool. So let's open this here. And while the other ones keep loading, you can use this one, for example, looks pretty cool. So let's download this, open in a new link. We're gonna experiment which graphic looks the best, okay? So let's take this one and we're gonna download. Don't choose vector graphic, just choose a PNG file and to take the biggest one. Okay, I'll see those things are finished. We download this one. So let's see what can we do with this. Let's bring it into Photoshop. Well, we can always lower the size and we can place it somewhere around here. Tired as a mother, for example. But in our case, this design doesn't really go very well with what we want. So let's try the other one. Okay, so we have this. Again, if you don't want to use colors and you are not very familiar with colors, don't use colors. Just take this image and desaturate. We go to adjustment and we choose black and white. Okay, and we have something like this. And do not worry, that thing is already applied to it. So you can get this and it still looks pretty cool. And if you want, you can take it to a whole new level. You can apply a level. And let's just clip it and let's make it brighter. Okay, why? And let's make it darker a little bit, because in this way, this graphic will match with your text if compared to the original one. So let me show you what I mean. Like this doesn't match with your text style. Like this, it matches better. And this one, for example, we can just control E, merge them together. Okay, and then we can just scale it down a little bit and try to find a good placement for it. You can place this somewhere around here, for example. Let's see, we want a bigger design. Somewhere here. Let's take the text and bring it on the top. And let's bring it down a little bit. Okay, let's bring this one down. Well, you can either let it like this or you can hit enter. Go inside the text, you can change the way that thing is presented. So we can choose the wrap style, and here we can choose, for example, arc lower, and we can get this, and it looks really good. Plus 50 looks okay. Okay, and I can increase the size. As I said, you want to make the text as bolded as possible. Okay, make sure the text is center and just place your design as you wish. Okay, as you can see, this one looks 100 times better than your original, and you haven't paid no money whatsoever. You don't have to spend no time for designing. You can just create this, and in the background, you can create some other effects to add here, like a frame that goes around the image. And feel free to experiment. And voila, the design looks much more better already. So as I said, this is how you can play around. Even if you have zero design skills whatsoever, you can still just take some images and place them together. And like I said again, you don't have Photoshop, don't worry, use Photopea. So, now, let's say you want to add some colors and yet you really do not know how to do colors. No problem. Just go on the top of everything, just go on the top of everything, click the plus button to add a new layer, go here and choose a gradient tool. If you use Photoshop, you have already a collection of gradients, but if not, you can create your own. So let's say I click here and I want to choose, for example, a red. So I will go for red, something like this. And then on the other side, I want probably a blue. So here I can check a blue. Don't go to these colors, they are way too strong, too saturated. So go somewhere on here, and let's see inside, probably I want to click here and add another color. Probably I can add a yellow. Let's drag this somewhere on here. Let's add another color. Let's see here, I can add a purple, and then click OK. Next, we want to draw inside. So let's go from the top to the bottom. So we have this, and you say like, oh my God, what's that? Okay, and now what we want to do, we just click multiply. Let's drag this underneath the preview layers. So let's close these ones. We only work with this. So we choose this to multiply, and voila, you can see it looks pretty cool already, isn't it? Look, looks amazing. And you can put this on a t-shirt. So let's see, if I bring the t-shirt, looks much more better. If I bring the phone case, it looks amazing, isn't it? Well, I hope you found these tips very useful, and please do try them. And if you struggle with them, let me know. And also you can use my videos about improving your work that teaches you how to create these kind of things very fast and easy. And everything that I show to you, you can do it in Photopea. I know I said that quite a lot. So by the way, this one, I will send it to you on Facebook. And I have another one created for you. This one, V is for virtual Valentine's, same as before. It's something similar. I'll send this to you as well. If you don't want to have all these extra lines, you just hide them and you only have the basic. And again, it looks better. What I did, I just took your text, I split it in half. V is for virtual, I put it on the top, Valentine's on the bottom. And I put a heart and a cybernetic person, and all these things, I just downloaded them from Pixabay. Okay, now let's head over to your store. Now we finished the coloring and improving the design and how to place your design on the t-shirt. So we covered this area very well. Another thing that I suggest you to do, and if you enjoy it, you can change your banner. The banner looks very good, but you can pop it up a little bit, make it more attractive. Try to show people what is your store about as the first look. So whenever I come to your shop for the first time, what do I see? Your banner. So here is a suggestion for you. Again, I will send it to you. So I recreated your banner. It's the same thing that you have, the same face. I just made the text a different shape. I introduced this ha 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 because your things are really funny. Your text information is really funny and I love it. And try to make here something like this that shows what is your store about. So you are using sarcasm, memes, quotes, and that is really good. So just let them know what you have. So I will send this banner to you as well. And again, you can just change what you already have. If you enjoy, you can use this one and you can add colors to them by double click here and just choose a color overlay or a gradient overlay. And you can change the colors based on your desire. Okay. And let's go back to the shop. So now we cover this, perfect. Now pay attention to this very well. When you're gonna plan to change your design, don't just go inside your shop. So I will go back to my own shop, okay, to my own Redbubble shop, and let me open the manage portfolio. Here I was doing a video about Easter eggs. Do not just go and choose here, edit and replace. Why? Your designs, they've been on your shop for a long period of time. And I already checked on them and I'll show it right now. You have a lot of tags and all these things push your design towards the end of the search engine. So what you want to do, just click copy setting, upload your new designs, and get rid of the old ones. So what do I mean by that? If you want to use this for your tired as a mother, perfect. Go to tired as a mother, make a copy of it, add this, and then click save, edit, optimize it for your product, and then delete your old design. In that way, this one is kind of like a fresh start. And it will, based on your tags, it has a higher chance to be pushed forward. Okay, now Another thing that you can do, let's have a look over your tags. Let's go here. Now, under the tags, I do like the tags are very nice, very well organized. Even though, for example, mama needs, this one you don't actually need it because you already edited inside here. So this is kind of repetition, and Redbubble will consider it as a tag spam. So be careful about that. It's better get rid of this, and the chance for you to be shown on the first, second, or third page is much more higher than having this repetition words. And this is a very good tip for you. Second thing, be careful. Boss babe is a trademark word, and let me prove it. If I go here to trademarks, by the way, I will make a video soon about it, how to use it. And here I write boss babe. As you can see, there are a lot of trademarks on it. Some of them are dead, but some of them are alive. This one is a brownie company, and this one is a cosmetic company. So from this point of view, you are safe. You have nothing to worry about because it has nothing related to clothing products. But on the other hand, let's see the other three. Well, what can you see here? This Boss Babe is for clothing, tops, button, headwear, footwear. So if you are planning to keep using this trademark work, there is a high chance that your design will be removed from Redbubble, especially if somebody is actually trying to search for this word, and then your design will be showed out, the algorithm will pick it up, and it will automatically remove your design. So please make sure that you don't use trademark words in your tags or title. Let's go back here. And by the way, in one of your designs, you do have the word Nike as a tag. Be careful, again, trademark. Another thing that you could do, let's use another one, tired as a mother. Okay. Another thing that you could do is try to limit your tags to maximum 15 tags. Do not go more than that, because the more tags you have, the algorithm will push you towards the end of the search engine. And why I'm saying that is because this is specified by them on their blog. So always try to constrain your tags within 15 tags. And another cool tip that for you, always add one tag that is your name tag. What do I mean by that? If you go here, let's go to Redbubble directly. Okay, let's see. I go here, and here I write the name of your shop, Lashan. Now, is there a chance for me to find you? Well, let's try to find out. Let's see, Control F, Lashan. 1 out of 7. So we have this, they use this word inside, but that's not your store. None of them are your store. Everybody just the name in a title. And that's a big no-no. But if I come here, for example, and I write VIP art, do you think I will find myself? Well, see, VIP art, that's my store. VIP art, VIP art, VIP art. And if I click here, as you can see, it will take me automatically. This is actually my store. And let's see, designed and sold by VIP Art. So if I go here, you will find my store. Well, how I done this and why I can find myself so easily? That's something for you to find out. Why? Because I had the name of my store written as one tag here, and that's fine. Do not over tag spam, because that will kind of push out the algorithm, but keep one tag with your store name. And that in that way, when somebody found you, but they never follow you, they can find you again just by writing Lashan. Don't write the Lashan shop. No, it's too much. Just Lashan or Lachan. I don't know how to pronounce it correctly. So I hope this tags information really helped you a lot. Again, restrict yourself to 15 tags as much as possible. And by the way, stay tuned, because next week I will present you what is my optimized way to make tags for Redbubble. And for me, so far, it works pretty well. And another thing that you should do, try to optimize your designs to only show one specific product. If you want stickers, go for stickers. If you want t-shirts, go for t-shirts. Don't put t-shirts and sweaters and or pullovers and all this combination or Canva. It will make the buyers confused. Even if you apply and optimize your design and all of these things, that's great. And take your time to do so. I highly recommend it. But let me show you an example of what I'm telling you in order to understand my point of view. Nice. So we head over to my shop. As you can see, these pattern designs, I have them applied to 86 products. But from these 86 products, I only display one. Why? Because this is what I think that it looks the best. So as you can see, I only have masks. If here under my collection, let's go here to collections. So if here I put on black products, all my designs here are placed on black products. But I think from my personal experience that this design will look the best on a mug. So I'm selling it as a mug. This is what I chose to display. Of course, this design is available on many other products and the customers can find out by themselves where they are placed, but I'm displaying them on a mug. If I go to the white ones, I don't want to display it on a mug because I already have a mug. So this time I want to display it on stickers. As I said, the background for this one is white. So I will only display this graphic on a t-shirt. For dragons, for example, another collection that I started, I only have it on t-shirts. And I have black t-shirts and white t-shirts, black t-shirts and white t-shirts. And this is what I've chosen from the start because this is what I have. And it makes it much more easier for the customer to find what they want from your shop. And another very important tip is create collection. Like here, you have Valentine's, you have Christmas memes. Separate them and create a collection for holiday, create a collection for memes, create a collection for sarcasm. What do I mean by that? If you come here, you see I have collections and I have 20 collections and that's a lot. And that's really very useful because sometimes when somebody visits your shop, they cannot really have access to all of your designs, especially if you have a lot of designs. So the easiest way for them is to choose collections and pick a collection from here that they want to present it to the world. Now, and besides these collections, when you go back to your store, you want to have a featured collection. You can see here, featured collections. But before I will show you the featured collection, let me show you very fast how you can create your custom, how you can create collections. Well, first thing first, you go to manage portfolio. Okay, select the graphics that you want to add them in a specific collection. Let's say the holiday collection. You click here under collections. This drop-up menu will come and you click plus. Okay, and here, before you click plus, here you just write holiday special. Okay, and then you click plus. When you click plus, this holiday special will be added here. You click on it and then you're gonna click add. When you click add, all of these designs that I have selected will go inside this holiday collection. Okay, and now you have this holiday collection. You're gonna make one for memes and one for sarcasm. Perfect, you have now collection into your stores. And those collections, let's go back. And those collections will be shown here. In your case, it will show here on the top of it. But again, we want to, besides these collections, we want to place another special collection that is called featured collection. Now, how to place this featured collection? Well, you go to your account settings, okay? Once in your account settings, here you go to shop settings. You have feature collection. Here you can pick any collections that you have and place it, and then you click save settings. When you've done that, that collection will be displayed at feature collection. This one shows the buyers that these designs are the best designs that you have and the best selling designs. And you can you can play them around, like every week change the collection. Another thing that you can do under account settings, go to message to buyer. This is very important and try to customize it. It makes a big difference. When somebody actually buys from you, you can want them to come back to you again. So you can say, thank you for purchasing from VIP Art and we are wishing you a pleasant day. Send us a bubble email if you are looking for a specific artwork that you desire. So whenever somebody purchases things from me, they get this. And I can tell you, right now I got 7 messages from my customers where they are looking for a specific Debbie designs. So because I know what they want, I can create a graphic for them and then I can put that as a, not as a public listing, but as a private listing, and I can send that link to the customer so they can purchase directly from there. And after a few weeks, I can make it public. I hope this tip helped you a lot. And I think this is everything that covers your store. All you have to do now is to just start, do it, no find excuses. Take one design per day. Will take you maybe 20 minutes to change, to create something really cool for it. And after these 20 minutes, will take you another half an hour to create a really good tags for them and create collection, make your life easier. And after that, delete the old design to only have the new ones into your shop. Put color variations. Okay, that's it for now. I wish you good luck with your shop. And if you plan on doing your changes, please keep me updated. I'm really curious about how this shop will change and will develop. So please keep in touch with me on Facebook and even on this YouTube video. Write down a comment below it and keep us updated a month from now how it looks like and how it's going. So I hope everybody found this video useful, and I hope you learned something new. And if you enjoyed, click the like button, also subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell. Why? Because we are uploading videos every single day in order to help you to improve your workflow and giving you design tips ideas. So until tomorrow, have a nice day. Bye bye.